Thank you for joining me for 5 Minute Arms. Grab a set of dumbbells and a mat. Let's get started. Stand up tall on your mat. You don't need your dumbbells. We're gonna do some rolling punches. So you're just rolling your arms one over the other. This is like doing a speed bag. So you could keep your legs still or you could do a little jog in place. And reverse direction. So you're bringing the palms towards your face instead of away. Make sure you don't hit yourself in the face. This is a great, simple exercise to bring a lot of heat into the upper body. Maintain nice, tall, lifted posture. Start to breathe nice and deep. Center yourself on those great arms you're about to build. All right, we are set. Grab your dumbbells. We're gonna move into rotational punches for 30 seconds. So you want a dumbbell in each hand, stand up tall. You're gonna punch side to side as you turn. Allow the foot that you're turning away from to pivot. Try to drive through your core and then extend through your arm. Make sure you're placing the weight out there and not throwing it out there. So all the muscles in your upper body are actively engaged. Move at a pace that works the best for you. We've got 30 seconds, your best on every exercise we do today. This is a little extension of our rolling punches warm up. Only a little more difficult, right? Your 30 seconds are almost up. Keep it going, punch it out. Try to keep that speed, keep that momentum. Awesome, you did it. Keep your dumbbells or grab a heavier set. We're doing alternating bent over rows. So you hinge forward, flat back. Alternate sides, so you're pulling one weight up towards the ceiling. And remember to squeeze those lats. You want to draw your elbows slightly towards your hips. Keep your belly button pulled in nice and tight, neck long. All right, that went fast, didn't it? Keep those dumbbells. Stand up for a second and then hinge back forward. Keep the arms long, but with a little bit of a bend at your elbows. Trace a line that's in line with your chest. Try to begin every single reverse fly in your upper back. Pinch those shoulder blades together. Let the rest of your arms just come along for the ride. Gotta keep that core in tight on this. I'm in a little mini squat here, so my hips are set behind my knees. Keep thinking about those upper back muscles. Oh my gosh, this workout goes so quick, doesn't it? 30 seconds, side lateral raises. Palms are face down, best posture, core tight. Slight bend in the elbows, and you're lifting those arms up. This is an awesome exercise for building your delts. That's what gives your shoulders that beautiful shape, those cuts in that upper half of your arm. And the weights don't have to raise any higher than shoulder height. Keep breathing while you're working these. Use a weight where you're getting a little bit tired, a little challenged by the end of the 30 seconds. You can get a lot done in a short amount of time as long as you've got the right weights. All right, you've got to meet me on the floor in a high plank. Set one weight off to the side. You're going to reach under, so I'm going to reach under with my left arm. Pull it through, set it off to the right as far as I can reach, and then alternate sides. Watch your hips on this one. You don't want the hips to start creeping up. You want to keep your core strong. My feet are a little bit wider than my hips, so you can even try wider than that if this exercise is totally brutal for you. Hopefully it is by now. And just keep pulling that weight through underneath your body, trying to keep your hips as still as possible. All right, you made it. 30 seconds. Flip onto your back. You need both weights. Raise the arms up straight over your chest. Legs are bent. And one arm at a time is going to fly to the side. Arm stays long. Weights stay in line with your chest. Slight bend in the elbows. So the arm that's not moving stays high. That shoulder stays plugged in. Alternating sides. This exercise is also really great for your core because you're doing a little, we're getting a little core stability in here just by splitting sides. I love splitting sides on exercises. You want to feel out how does one arm feel different than the other. Does one arm tend to take over and dominate the movement? And again, make sure you're challenged by the end of this short little time we've got together. All right, 30 second dead man push-ups. I'm only gonna do 5 on this one. So start in your high plank, hands a little wider as slow as you can go, lower yourself all the way down until you're resting on the floor. Push yourself back up. So the goal is slow, 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 slow. If we work those areas of our push-ups where we tend to get stuck, you will get stronger on your push-ups. So push-ups are tough for you. This is the exercise to do. Same with those chest flies. All right, I think I'm on number four. Aim for five. Try to get five out of these 30 seconds. Even if it's tough, you want it to be brutal. On my last one here, slow as I can go. And we made it to the end of our 5-minute arm workout. You did it. High five if you can hold your arms up. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want more, you can subscribe to my email list or subscribe to this channel. The only difference is on the email list, you're going to get some behind-the-scenes tips. Thank you. I'll see you soon.